street, have their hands up in the air and just running. But now today, if you run, there's a possibility that something can happen.
Peace to make us change, to do different things, to start thinking different ways about each other and start coming together under love. Because at the end of the day, we all want to leave this world the same way. Right? So what's the argument? What's the beef? What's the problem? We need to get it together and start becoming more accepted. Okay.
There really is I must commend Askari Sowande for her incredible organization. Don Jordan.
Hey, Patrice.
Hey, Patrice Williams. Nairobi. Kenya Mack. Brian, Pastor Brian Harris.
Terrence, Pastor Nichols.
Pastor Nichols.
Miss Betty Walker
Sharai. Thank you so much for doing this.
Michelle Adolf.
So let's give a round of applause to the organizers.
Thank you.
On behalf of the city of Vallejo and the city council, this is really important. I don't know about you, but I was just stunned about another shooting yesterday, you know? Was an exchange student from Pakistan. And this unbelievable sad irony is that in January, said he was going to suspend all related assistance to Pakistan until they could prove they were committed to fighting terrorism. And one of their children was murdered in the United States in Santa Fe, Texas. I really want to have just a moment of silence for those victims. And I had things that I wanted to say today, and they sort of got taken back by that incident yesterday. But what I did want to say is, I love that we were chanting plant justice, grow peace on the way down here. And I was reading about a CIA operative who actually worked in Thailand with those secret prisons, and he was so devastated by it that he came back to the United States and got a job as a rookie in the Savannah, Georgia Police Department. And what he wanted to do there is build resilience, build a garden. And so this is actually building the garden. Bringing us all together as a community is a step towards building a garden and building resilience in the city of Vallejo. And I also want to thank Sergeant Brett Garrick, who was on the Vallejo Police Force, and I think he had a hand in organizing this and helping get through the permitting process, which was a difficult process that we would like to change. And we have our mayor, Bob Sampine, who also helped move that through. Thank you so much, Bob Sampine. So I want to end with a quote that this police officer in Savannah, Georgia said about being a police officer. No military force can end terrorism, just as firefighters can't end fire and cops can't end crime. But there are ways to build a resilient society. It can't be on the government contract that says in 6 months show us the results. It has to be, I live here. This is my job forever. That's a way to build a resilient society. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much.
I just wanted to put that out there and just say humbly myself, I appreciate you and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Woo! Okay, so the next person that we have is Don Jordan from the African American Alliance that has something to say.
First, I want to give honor to God. I also want to thank everybody for coming out today. The African American Alliance is a collaborative organization. We're trying to get the different organizations in Vallejo to move in one direction. Woo! Yeah. Vallejo has too long been splintered by different races, different ethnicities, and the crazy part is that we are one of the most diverse cities in the United States of America. Woo! As a realtor, Vallejo is in the top five of all cities in the United States as a place to live. We have people come from all over the Bay Area that want to live in our town. But we tolerate people talking bad about our city. And I'm from New Jersey, and I can tell you, Vallejo is a great place to raise a family, and a great place to live, where else can you get weather like this? But on a more serious note, we as a community have to give dialogue to what's going on in our nation. We are now seeing police, people using the police as weapons against minorities. They'll call minorities because they're having a problem at a Waffle House in South Carolina. They're having problems at a Walmart. Somebody walking down the street, they have a problem with a 12-year-old walking in the park with a play gun. And these people end up dead. And when you take a life, you take all they have. When you take a life, they cannot come back and speak to you again. And all I'm asking is we as the citizens of Vallejo, we as members of this community, have a dialogue with our police department, with our sheriff department, with our judges, and with the powers that be, that we address these issues that are nationwide, and we don't want them to happen here in our town, here in our county, because we are citizens of the world. And until we stand up for our rights and our livelihood and our lives, then we will be ignored. As the old saying goes, if you're not sitting at the table, you're on the menu. And I don't want to be on anybody's menu. Thank you so much.
This is Miss Brady. Take your time.
Size in the Bay Area. And I absolutely love this town. One of the proudest moments of my life has been when the city council and the mayor nominated me to be the senior rep for the city of Vallejo. Seniors are valuable people, y'all.
Yeah.
You know, we have lived a long time. If you could compare all of the living that we have done and couple that with the experience that we have and then put a little bit of passion in there, we can get shit done.
Woo-hoo!
We can get it done. So, you know, we do need to come together. It is really time for us to look for the similarities and honor our differences. And if we can do that as a community, there is nothing that can defeat us. Vallejo, as someone said, is the most racially diverse city in this town, in this country, probably. And even with that diversity, you know, it does not mean that we all have to get along. What it means is that we can all learn from each other. We can all learn from the different cultures, the different life experiences that we have had. So I am very proud to live here in Vallejo. I'm very proud that the city of Vallejo thought enough of me and that I had gotten old enough to be honored as a senior. And I want to let you all know that there's a new group in town, new sheriffs in town, senior sheriffs, and it's called Seniors Count Vallejo. We meet every Tuesday. So if you guys want to put your word in there and talk about how seniors count, if you want to know what we can do and be there to support us as we emerge from right now, which is a ball of confusion around senior services that we can talk about. If somebody wants to talk to me later about that, I'm more than willing. But if we can put our energy behind our seniors and our young people and our millenniums and all of the folks here in Vallejo, we can be one tribe with justice for all. Thank you.
Yes.
Hello, everybody. A lot of you already know me, some of you don't. My name is Mina Diaz, and I'm the founder and director of the Diaz Herrera Centro Latino. Woo! I founded and I direct the CEN Latino program, which is a program at both Vallejo and Jesse Bethel High Schools that work with the Latino students. I'm very happy to see so many people here. I'm happy to see such a diverse group of people here. But I also want to add something that I was talking to my friend Lisa from the Vallejo Peace Project, which is amazing. That the diversity is great, but diversity is nothing without acceptance. Acceptance of each other. Now, I'm gonna talk about what I know, what I live, and what I breathe, and that is, I'm an immigrant from from Mexico, and I'm going to talk to you about the violence and the hard situation that immigrants are living right now, which we could use some peace too. You know, our families are being destroyed, our families are being torn apart, and no, this is not in the central or east part of the county, this is in Solano County. Just last week, we had a mother take her two kids in Fairfield to the school, drop them off, turn around, walk to her car, and immigration officials picked her up. Sent her to Richmond, then sent her to Fairfield, then back to Richmond. We're part of the rapid response team, and we were trying to locate her so that we can work in helping, you know, with the kids. Luckily, the father's there, so he was able to get the kids. These kids are 8 and 6. I don't know about you guys, but I needed my mom at that age. Shoot, I still need my mom right now, and I'm 51. So not caring and saying it's them is inappropriate. Not wanting to help is the way we all fall. Unless we all start to unite, you know, my kids are just as important as all of your kids, and those that don't have kids might have, you know, nieces, nephews, friends, heck, whoever. Let's try and work together. You know, enough is enough. As we say in Spanish, basta. Ya basta. I'm going to ask all you guys to say it. Ya basta.
Ya basta.
Say, ya basta.
Ya basta.
Enough is enough. And in Vallejo, we're very blessed because a lot of us work together. You know, if you see who's here, you know, I know most of the people here, and we need to work together, but we need to reach out to our millennials. I don't see a lot of young kids here, so we need to start including them. They are the future. They're the ones that are going to take over.